If you enjoy the content on this channel, please like and subscribe. All the Light We Cannot See is an American drama limited series directed by Shawn Levy and developed by Stephen Knight for Netflix. Based on Anthony Doerr's Pulitzer Prize winning novel of the same name, it stars Aria Mia Loberti, Mark Ruffalo and Hugh Laurie. The four-part series follows the lives of two teenagers during the height of World War II. Marie-Laure, a blind French girl, and Werner, a German boy forced to join and fight for the Nazi regime. The limited series was released on November 2nd, 2023. In March 2019, Netflix and 21 Laps Entertainment acquired the rights to develop a limited television series adaptation of the novel, with Shawn Levy, Dan Levine, and Josh Barry executive producing. In September 2021, it was announced that Netflix had given the production series an order consisting of four episodes, with Stephen Knight writing the series and Levy directing all episodes. Filming took place between March and July of 2022 in Budapest, Saint-Malo, and Villefranche-de-Rouge, Ariane, department of southern France, with the main street scenes being filmed in the latter. The town was chosen for its ancient central square, similar to Saint-Malo before the World War II deconstruction, and for its familiar 1940s-style streets. The shooting in Villefranche-de-Rouge took place from July 5th to the 20th in 2022. A large part of the town was adapted for all production needs. There are some notable differences from the original book, though. Etienne, the great-uncle of Marie-Laure, dies in the series. In the book, however, he was put in prison and eventually got out and reunited with Marie-Laure. Werner's extended backstory in the book from his childhood and training with the Nazi was condensed at the start of the series, and near the end his role in saving Marie-Laure was also significantly altered. In the book, he killed Reinhard von Rumpel to protect Marie-Laure, while in the series, Werner helped Marie-Laure by fighting Reinhard von Rumpel after distracting him from finding her, but it's Marie in the end who managed to fatally shoot von Rumpel. Another key difference is the extended encounter and a moment of romance between the two main characters, which did not happen in the book. In the book, Marie-Laure and Werner met only for a short time after he saved her at her hideout and before he was captured by the Allied soldiers. In the series, they instead had a few more hours together at her place while they had a slow dance and kiss. Book author Anthony Doerr has shared that over the years he had received feedback from lots of readers reflecting their disappointment at the brief encounter of the two main characters near the end of the story, which had been built up throughout the separate storylines in the book. He saw the miniseries as a remedy for this to the fans of the original story who wanted more. In addition, the series ended after the teenage Marie-Laure throws the diamond Sea of Flames into the ocean, while in the book the storyline moved on to decades later when an old Marie-Laure, now over 80 and once again living in Paris, received the miniature house and the key that once belonged to her back from Werner's sister. With this major removal of the storyline in later years, Jutta, Werner's sister, therefore does not reappear, and she and Marie-Laure never cross paths in the series. Some interesting trivia notes. This is Aria Mia Loberti's acting debut. She was a PhD candidate when she auditioned for an open call for actresses who are blind or vision impaired. Her service dog accompanied her during the filming in Budapest. All the German actors dubbed themselves in the German dub of the film. Now this is one of these series when I saw the trailer firstly. I knew I would be captivated by this show. Firstly, it had a good cast, and secondly, I love World War II based stories. Of course, now this is a complete work of fiction based on the real Liberation Battle of Saint-Malo. The story, of course, is set when the Nazis had occupied France, and it delves into the lives of its main characters very well, and sort of sets the tone for how complicated, difficult, and scary life must have been under this oppressive rule. The first episode, for me, I found very weak. I didn't like the score by James Newton Howard. The show just felt somewhat uneven, and was sort of confused in what it was portraying. For me, it almost felt like a sort of child's version of World War II. I'm happy to say that the show does progress much better, and the rest of the episodes really did grab me, and I ended up thoroughly enjoying the series. Look, this is by no means a World War II classic, and there are some fantastic real tales that I would highly recommend rather than this, but in the same breath though, I do feel the series does capture some of the more complicated aspects of World War II. I also like now that the story approaches the source material from two sides. Often, of course, the Germans are portrayed as the big baddies in these type of movies, but here we see another aspect. We see the life and times of Werner, a man who was talented, a genius some would say, and how he's forced and bullied into the Nazi youth camps, and pushed against his own will to serve the Nazi regime. It just adds a human side to the German experience, and makes you realise that not every German was bad. Aria Mia Loberti is superb in her debut performance here. She plays Marie-Laure with a sense of earnest naivety, yet a sort of wisdom beyond her years, and the mere fact that of course that she is visually impaired, really sort of added credence to the role. Having heavyweights like Hugh Laurie and Mark Ruffalo sort of added gravitas to the show. Hugh Laurie here is particularly good as Etienne LeBlanc. He adds a sort of calmness and gentle aspect to this role. The one character there, however, that really annoyed me was Mark Ruffalo's take on Daniel LeBlanc. I just found him annoying and almost like he was misplaced within the show. Not in terms of the role, but in terms of the actor playing the role. It looks like he was given the script for a Disney-friendly children's book, rather than a World War II epic. Lars Edinger plays Reinhold von Rumpel very well. He's the sort of atypical, evil Nazi. But he brings the character to life perfectly, and really sort of adds to his antagonistic role. The attention to detail in terms of the scenery really transports you back to the 1940s in France, and gives you a real lifelike feel of what it must have been like to be at the ground level at Saint-Malo during the 1944 liberation push by the Allied forces. Look, this is an exceptionally detailed and well-made show. And it's funny that a show like this started off for me almost somewhat iffy, and then became so good and enjoyable that I really felt quite emotionally attached to the characters by the end of its four-episode run. From its well-made story, good performances by most of the cast, and attention to detail in capturing the desperate despair yet hope of 1940s France, All the Light We Cannot See gets an 8.5 out of 10.